Washington State is a wonderland of many contrasts. A long and varied coastline on the west side, and it's only a short drive to the quiet sylvan lake in the shadows of magnificent mountains. Tomorrow you can water ski in dry and sunny sagebrush country. 2 hours away, a 50-mile lake probes to the heart of the Cascade Mountains. Wherever you are, it's only a hop, skip, and jump to cool mountain streams, well-stocked with rainbow trout. Hundreds of picturesque islands are easily reached by private boat, chartered cruise, or public ferries. As for boats, we have things from the world's fastest speedboats to little dinghies with an outboard motor. It's all part of our Washington State way of life. Family life and family fun are typically centered around the water. Children growing up in Washington State come into this way of life as soon as they can walk, or before. Ownership figures don't include craft in this particular class, but maybe there's some advantage in blowing up your own breeze. If you come to Washington on a western route, you may begin your visit on the mighty Pacific. Enjoy beachcombing on miles of hard-packed beach, or dig for famous razor clams. And there he is. From Washington State's southern coast, on around the Strait of Juan de Fuca, into and all around Puget Sound, there are many saltwater fishing ports. Here at Westport, you can charter a boat for some of the world's finest fishing. The king salmon in these waters run up to 60 pounds. Salmon fishing is a great tradition in our state. Many communities have annual salmon derbies, and there are usually large prizes, such as several new cars. Proceeds over and above the prizes go to charity. Fishing out of Westport near Twin Harbor State Park is especially good in July or August. You can get the facts from the Fish and Wildlife Service on other ruins and preferred spots all around the western Washington shoreline. Less than 2 hours west of Spokane is Grand Coulee Dam, largest concrete structure in the world, nearly a mile long and twice as high as Niagara Falls. The tourist provides lectures and complete information on the dam and the tremendous water development of which it is a part. It's an awesome sight, but more important, it produces electrical energy, provides water for irrigation, and has vastly extended the recreational resources of the state. Franklin D. Roosevelt Lake, created in the river 125 miles up to the Canadian border, and then more miles beyond. Today you can go the whole way by boat if you like. If you enter Washington State from the east on 410 or 95, you come over the Snake River at Clarkston. This is where Lewis and Clark reached the Snake more than 150 years ago. But they, with their pirogues and canoes, never saw anything like the fleet of the Clarkston boating enthusiasts today. Let's follow the Snake south and west now till the wheat fields stop. Here is where Lewis and Clark first saw the mighty river of the west, at the confluence of the Snake and the Columbia. This is North Central Washington, where our central wheat plateau comes almost to the shore of Lake Chelan. From east to west, you drive in off US 2. From north or south, it's on the Okanagan Caribou Trail. Any day, you can take a 50-mile cruise up the lake. Around the town of Manson, there are 4,000 acres of incomparable apple orchards. On the opposite shore, Lake Chelan State Park. On up to the head of the lake, at lunchtime, you can visit beautiful Rainbow Falls. There is no road, probably never will be a road, into this point in the Cascade Range. But there are regular flights by air as well as boat runs from Chelan. In May, there unfolds in Seattle an incomparable sight. Yacht clubs blossom out in the holiday mood. It's the opening day of the yachting season. The ranking royalty for this year's seafare are all on hand. Guns fire a salute to the new season, and a gigantic water parade gets underway. The Lake Washington Ship Canal is soon filled with tugboats, schooners, yachts, cabin cruisers, ketches, and catamarans. The boats Puget Sound are owned not only by the Coast Guard, by industrialists and professional men, but also by salesmen, clerks, and mechanics. One reason why the productivity of our workers is among the highest in the nation. In June, daylight gleams over Seattle at 3 a.m. It's still twilight about 10 in the evening. Men go fishing before they go to work. Families get in 4 to 6 hours of boating after the end of the working day. Now Seattle is building up to its great seafair. The waters, fresh and salt, hum with every kind of activity for old and young. Through the summer, Puget Sound vibrates at an ever-rising pitch. As the climax of seafair approaches at the end of July, hydroplane fever grips the whole state. Ask any hydroplane racer from the East Coast or Detroit, and he'll tell you he's never seen anything else like it anywhere. The pits on Lake Washington are filled with unlimited hydros from all over America. Counting test runs and qualifying time trials, the roaring speedboats dominate the lake for about a week. Hundreds of thousands of people come to watch the race. Dignitaries and celebrities are always on hand. A large percentage of the boats you saw a minute ago are now tied up to log booms around the course. The speedboats are king today. Whether it's Gold Cup, as usually happens in Seattle, or Seafair Trophy Race, or the Apple Cup on Lake Chelan, Washington State is wild about hydroplanes. A quarter to a half million people surround the course. Many come early for a good spot on the lake shore and stay all day. It's a fitting climax to a long series of street parades, aqua theater presentations, and scores of other special events. When it's over, only Mount Rainier seems to view the scene with much detachment. On this occasion, Miss United States joins the governor and Bob Hope at the end of an exciting day. Nothing will be quite like it again. Ever, until another year rolls around. Meanwhile, fish are jumping on the line and fun on Washington State's waterways continues throughout the year. After fishing like this, it's easy to doze off into pleasant dreams like this. Whatever the time of year you visit Washington State, you'll discover a rare new world of color and variety. 1,000 sights to make you reach for the camera. Everything from people and events to nature in all her glory, to man-made wonders of the world. A land of hospitality and vivid contrasts. The kind of fun you like.